Well, the moment has passed. Back to work.
G'day all, Mr. Paladin here with How a Spy Thinks number 88. A long time ago, and in other How a Spy Thinks, I did this thing called number crunching, where I was saying you can hang out in certain spaces where only about 5% of the time somebody might actually see you. So I'm going to show some examples of this just to kind of prove it. I'm putting on a disguise, but I'm putting on a friendly disguise so the enemies don't see me with their spawning warhacks. And with the exception of the crazy heavy there, who seems to be down with just chilling, nobody notices. Now what's odd about this spot though is the way the shadows are cast is I should be casting a shadow on the wall behind me, so I think a scout comes along in a moment, able to see the shadow, quickly flicks a corner. But he was pretty cool himself. If you're wanting to see the real action of this video though, just jump ahead to about the 3 minute mark.
Thanks, mate.
And there we go. He's pretty cool. Have a bit of fun. And we go on about our business in true TF2 form. And you don't have to be outside of their spawn, I'll show you some other places. But for real, nobody turns around, especially at spawn. You often have to go to spawn as a spy in order to take out teleporters and stuff that hang around here. And, you know, you take the odd stab every now and then when the opportunity arises. But you could sit here for most of a day and the only people who would notice you are the engineers running back to spawn to set stuff up, or a wounded player, or maybe, you know, the heavy throwing a sandwich. Let's adjust our spot here. Oh, we get a call for spy round here. That sniper down there must have heard the decloak. Let's watch him. Oh yeah, he saw me. Did you see him? Good man, good man. You're a part of the 5%. I know the heavy's about to spawn. I saw it in the HUD at the top. Have to take out the teleporter to do anything like this because I need them to actually walk from the spawn. Looks like one of the engineers has a jag, the other has a Eureka effect, so the Eureka is going to teleport himself back to spawn. But there's going to be some time. Somebody's going to spawn, that medic's going to spawn. I'll take you to another spot where it's out of the line of sight, and that's the whole thing, right? So long as they don't have spawning warhacks on and you're not in a disguise, they don't check here, they don't look, they just go on past, they just want to get to their objective. You could sit here for a good long time up until, you know, the first point's captured anyway, and just wait for your opportunity, wait until you want to move. It's so good even this engineer coming back to spawn doesn't even look up here so long as I don't move. Here's another little nook that I use often. I'm disguised as one of my own teammates, but it doesn't really matter. I'll have to show you another example of standing in that spot. They really don't look there. And stuff like that is all over the map. Just think in your mind when you're walking out of a spawn, when you're going to your objective, what do you not turn to look at? Nobody turns to look at that. You're too busy wondering about getting around the next corner. So long as they don't hear the sound, you're usually good. Now, spawning warhacks are a problem. I take a teleporter here, and the first thing I notice is a sniper that's not really in a sniper position, so I kind of home in on him, and then once I see he's going the wrong way, I kind of clue in that he could be a spy. And sure enough, my instincts check out as he goes after the heavy. Spawning warhacks, man, I wish I never introduced them to the game. You've got to do things as spy to actively avoid being seen, even though you are staying out of line of sight. Each time I'm throwing on a disguise, I try and do it while I'm underneath a cloak so the disguise smoke does not get seen. When I decloak, I try to decloak in places where enemies aren't gonna see me, and that sentry gun reaches over here. My kunai letting me get a couple stabs, but I could not get that stab on that sniper that I wanted because the sentry gun would have taken me out. I check my disguise here, but I'm like, you know what? They have an awful lot of snipers. Let's just throw on a sniper disguise. And let's have a look at that nest, but it is much too busy to get into. I see a teleporter. It's not active yet. But it looks like it was active enough for him to remove the sapper from the other end. I might be able to use that later. Something got bumped behind me. So without knowing what, I just shift to a different spot somewhere I'm not going to get bumped. Looks like we got a pyro flaming around now. Doesn't matter, these snipers are doing the sniper thing, doing a bit of hard scoping. Getting a little blinked. I love the position of that sentry gun. That sentry gun is doing pretty much exactly what I was saying the spy should do. It's in a spot where people just don't look. Maybe I should have taken that teleporter. I should have left it up. But it doesn't matter, they took down the nest anyway. Push the payload in for the win. Always going through progressions in my mind, like, I'm thinking maybe I can hit the medic if I'm here. No, let's not go here. Let's go up the stairs. No, let's bump the stairs and then go up it. This is a dynamite spot right here. I'm looking at the heavy. No, looking to the medic. No, looking to the sniper. There we go. You're all alone, big man. You're all alone, and you're in the wrong neighborhood. That's what I'm talking about. You just got to get the one stab. Then after that, everything else is gravy. A lot of pyros around now, very paranoid, so paranoid that in fact they're spinning 360 on the payload. But that doesn't stop a spy like us, does it? Who cares if he's cleared the cart? Let's stab him and the demo man. Oh no, we catch the Razorback. I wanted that demo man. He's not thinking spy. He's just walking from spawn. Especially the slower classes. They don't take time to look around. They're too busy trying to get to where they're going because the walk is so long. Can I get in behind this pyro? No, ooh, he's doing a random crazy Ivan. And here's something I don't like doing, but it is profitable, I guess. Throwing on a teammate disguise outside of their spawn. I can see at the top of the HUD who's spawning, so we've got two pyros. We'll let the first pyro go, because that second pyro might slide out behind him. Oh, and there was a soldier there as well. Okay, so this should be a pyro. There we go. Gotcha. Oh, there was something else there. I could have died to that soldier. That AFK soldier who was just hanging out in spawn. Yeah, not very fond of that. Because while there's reasons to be around the enemy spawn, you don't really want a spawn camp, but, you know, it's all fair play because it's outside of the spawn. Enemy demo man have no trouble jumping with a sticky jumper, getting to your spawn and just camping out there, destroying stuff, killing anyone who spawns. A heavy medic, if they get the chance to get to your spawn, will sit outside your spawn door. Heck, even an engineer, if he can get a level 3 gun up to your spawn, he'll do that. So, a spy being at spawn, while it is cheesy, dang, pyro. A spy at the spawn, while it can be cheesy, is not unexpected. I mean, anytime you're outside of the spawn, you could get hit. At least the spy doesn't, you know, throw down a sticky trap and explode it when the door opens, or doesn't sit underneath the door and stop it from closing like heavies can. Ooh, up the stairs. Ooh, I fell down the stairs. I'll get you at the top of the stairs. Not a stair stab, but a stab at the stairs. And that's the whole thing about these clips, right? It's not about the trick stabs. Sure, you should know your trick stabs. Definitely know your trick stabs, but you don't have to trick stab this. He's got his attention elsewhere. Oop, bumped the engineer. The engineer went to spawn. And you should know your trick stabs. I mean, be prepared to do them. I'll even call out in this footage where I was thinking that a trick stab might be an opportunity. And I was preparing for it. Hey, nice preparation there with the sticky trap. Let's see if we can get this distracted guy in the corner. Oh, shoot him, shoot him. Oh, first shot hit a rock. But there we go. Give a little nod to the demo man. Let's see, what have we got here? I'm using this bridge a lot. Decloaking underneath the bridge. People aren't noticing it. Because it's out of eyesight, isn't it? The only thing I've got to watch is I do have a disguise on, so while I come out of cloak, people who are spawning could see that I'm decloaking underneath the bridge. Let's do it again. Heavy's looking like a tasty target, and he is. Get away from this pyro. Get a little scorched. Pick up the health pack. Look back. No trick stab. Okay. Ooh, there was another spy around. He just took out the engineer's gear. Can we get this soldier? Yes, we can. Whoa, what was that other spy? Other teammate spy, I think. There are two of us. You've got to be aware of the other spy. You never know when he's going to be doing stuff. You don't want to step on each other's toes. I'll leave that engineer alone because he was staring me down. And there's the other spy. He's causing a distraction. He's in the corner. I can get the stab on the heavy. Thank you. And that demo man was just dazed and confused. Let's get out of here. I love using chaos, but I don't want to get caught up in it. I don't want to decloak here because it's in front of everyone, but I check my back real quick. Whoa, what is that calisthenics from that spy? Doing some yoga. Let's have a go at this engineer this time. No, he dropped down like I dropped down earlier. Pick up the heavy. Thank you. And this is why what I talk about with spy is just tips and not a rule. I mean, if it was a rule that I had to decloak in an unseen corner, I would have never decloaked there. But I saw the opportunity. There was a bunch that had just spawned. There's probably no one spawning after them. And I just decloaked in front of God and everybody. Got a quick stab, got out of there. Let's just escape from this. Oh, we catch a little bit of a bump as I wanted the health and ammo that was there. Not that I needed the health, but the ammo would have been good. There's that engineer. He looked like he noticed me. That was weird. Or was there another teammate there? I think the other spy was there, Delta. Whoa. Nope. Don't want anything to do with that. Got super lucky there. I could have been dead. Fortunately, he was looking at my teammate Pyro. Used the demo man's charge to hide a decloak. Take a quick look back, make sure nobody saw that decloak. Because there was no corner, it wasn't a hidden space. You gotta be sneaky. So another example of it not needing to be a hidden space is this spot right here. These soldiers are gonna jump up. They're not looking here. Nobody's looking here. The people coming out of the spawn aren't looking there. Let's see if we can clean up that other soldier. With the help of our team, distracting them. Just doing the spy thing. Using that spot again, seeing a squad go in towards the payload. Getting a nice bit of a chain. Just make sure you're not being seen. Control what the enemy sees. Because they can't kill what they don't see. Well, they can kill what they don't see. But it has to be very lucky. Didn't we do a video recently about lucky spy and unlucky spy? That's what I'm talking about. Now, be sure when you go to sap a level 3 gun not to throw in a disguise. I quickly realized my mistake there. That spy just teleported. There we go. I mean, it's not so bad to run around with no disguise at all. I've done videos about that as well. I have to do another one. Let's see, he took the sapper off of the teleporter. Soldier is looking this way. Again, I'm operating near their spawn. Thanks for the heal, medic. There we go. Trick stab opportunity. Oh, let's get away. He didn't blink me. Let's go. But when this happened, I went into cloak before I did my disguise, and I caught this. It's time to get off TF2 for today. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Be sure and check out the other How a Spy Thinks videos. Or, in particular, the one about number crunching, which ties into the same sort of idea. Be sure to like and subscribe and comment for more like this.